Hello everybody. Today we are going to talk about how to use EBSCO to create a journal alert. And a journal alert is when you get an email every time EBSCO adds to its holdings a new issue of a journal that you can access the full text of. So let's say, for instance, in this case I'm going to be looking at Chronicle of Higher Education, which EBSCO has the full text of. Now, to keep yourself from having to check back every few days or every few weeks or whatever to see when a new issue is posted in there, you can have an alert set up where EBSCO will send you an email every time they get a new issue in there that you can access the full text on. So I'm going to show you how I would do this. There are different ways to do it, but this is the way that I do it, and I think kind of the quickest way to do it. What I do, instead of starting out on the search page for EBSCO, I go into where it says publications. So right up here on top on this blue bar where it says publications, I'm going to click there, and I'm going to look up Chronicle of Higher Education in this second box. If you just search here, if you type this in, it'll just go back to searching articles, but we want to search for the headings for journals. So I'm going to go into this box here to browse through publications, and that's probably all I need to type in there. When I hit browse, okay, found it. So there it is. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to open this up. And if you wanted to, you could browse through all the issues they have, all the back issues. Any one of these that you open up will open the full text. And click on that to close that back up. You could go into any year they have if you want to do that. But what we're really trying to do here is we want to know every time they publish a new issue online that we can have access to. Now, where we're going to do that is right here where it says alert. But this won't work correctly until we sign in. So if I click on alert right now and click on email alert, it'll say, okay, you must sign in to send email alerts. Sign in. So I'm going to cancel this. Let's go back here. Let me show you where you sign in. Now, if you haven't signed in before, I'll show you where you can create your own sign in. Basically, this is where you can personalize EBSCO so that it's not just a general search, but you can kind of tell it what to do for your own search needs. So I'm going to go to sign in here. Now, if you haven't done this before, you would just go to where it says create a new account. And then it's pretty similar to creating a free email account. You type in all your information here. Probably the hardest part is, as like a lot of these things, is to find a username that hasn't been used by someone else. So if all else fails, use your S number. Putting your S number in here will be unique. That's a unique enough number, no one else will have used that. So let's say you get that. What you do, you type in all your information, then click Save Changes, and it would create an account for you. I already have an account, so I'm going to sign in with my account here. And notice there's a lot of cool things that happen when you sign in. Look at the folder's empty right now. When I click Log In, that folder will change. Okay, now you see that little piece of paper there. That means that the folder has articles in it. Now, you've seen in this session I haven't done any searching for articles, but I've saved from previous sessions, I've saved these articles here. So in my general area I have these articles that have been saved, and I have all these subfolders over here, all these subfolders of articles that I've saved in here that I can keep as long as I want, and I can also delete them at any time that I want. But let me go back here. I'm going to click the back button to go back to the Chronicle of Higher Education. So I want to get an alert every time a new issue is published online in EBSCO that I can access. So now I'm going to click on alert. Email alert, because I want to get an email. I'm just going to tell it what email to send it to. So I just need to type in my email address here. And with these results format, if it's brief, it's just going to give you the titles of the articles and links to get into them. Or if you want a little bit more detail, click on Detailed, and Detailed would give you the titles of the articles and a little abstract, so you could kind of read about each article to make sure it's something you're interested in before you click on it. I'm going to go with Detailed so I can see those abstracts, and maybe all the information I need I can get from the abstracts, but if I want more information I can click on the link for the article and go directly into it. Bibliographic Manager, this is if you have some kind of a citation management software on your computer, like EndNote, for instance, you could have it forwarded to that. I don't do that, I've never done that, so I'm just going to click Detailed for mine. And then now let's go into these advanced settings. So right now it's just going to keep going. It's going to give you this alert for, it's just going to keep sending this to you every month, every time they get a new issue. Let's say you want to be a little more specific. Now, you don't need to do this, But let me just, if I went into advanced settings down here, let's say I just wanted to do this for a year or a few months or whatever to see if I liked it, and then I could, it would go away, and then here it's telling me I'm just creating this alert. It's pretty quick there. Let's say I want to run this alert for 6 months to see if I like it. You could also say 1 month, 2 month, so that if you don't like it, it would go away without you having to go in and reprogram this. But I'm going to put in here for 6 months. And then if I don't like it, I can just let it go and it won't, it'll stop running. So I've got that. I'm going to click save and continue, and it's just sent me an email telling me, okay, we're going to send you these alerts. And that's all you need to do. Now it's set up, and every month I'm going to get an email every time a new issue of the Chronicle of Higher Education comes into EBSCO that I can access the full text on, and I'll have all the links come right into my email, and I can link into all the articles even without opening up EBSCO. It'll open up the articles just from my email there. So that's pretty much all you need to know about this. It's really easy, and it kind of makes EBSCO a lot more useful. You're kind of having EBSCO at your command, kind of programming it behind the scenes to do what you want it to do without having to go in every week and check to see about these issues. Anyway, there you go. Any questions, contact your local librarian. If that happens to be me, that's great. Or if you're on one of the other campuses, contact those librarians, and we'd be more than happy to walk you through how to do this one-on-one. Thanks a lot.